what's up, you guys? Chelsea Briggs here, coming to you from South by Southwest 2015, joined by the lovely Laura Welsh.
Hey.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Having a good South by?
Yeah, amazing South by.
A favorite performance that you've had here, or any good stories?
I think definitely Hype Hotel was amazing. Mm-hmm. But last night we did Stubbs, which was very
so cool.
Yeah,
that's just such a cool venue.
It's really good. Yeah, it's good. It's kind of cool. So because I've come out here, we've done like a strip show, so it's been kind of nice to play like a balance of like the more like intimate vibe gigs.
You have a lot to celebrate because your album Self Control is out now.
Yes, yeah.
So that's gotta be cool coming into a festival like this where everyone's buzzing about you and your talent. And do you kind of feel that energy around you?
Yeah, it's been amazing. Like it's quite strange because these are like, you know, I've only done like a couple of shows in the States. So this is like my first run at it, and I think it's the first show I did was kind of like people in the audience were like singing lyrics back, which was the first time I've had
that.
It's
gotta be
here.
Such a great feeling as an artist to just see the audience respond that way.
Yeah, it was kind of surreal just to have people like singing the lyrics back and stuff. So
were you nervous to bring your music to the States? Like, is it a different set of nerves at all? Or
I think so. It's just been good because I think for me, like early on, it's been like the support out here has been incredible. Even with like TV syncs and like Grey's Anatomy really
it's
early on picked
so
up
great.
On my track. So it's been amazing to have that kind of support and people, like just a different avenue for people to hear the music.
And it's been a really big deal that your song was in 50 Shades of Grey soundtrack, because obviously I feel like that's all anyone's been talking about for the past year is that movie. So have you seen it? I'm guessing you have. Okay.
Yeah. I went to the premiere in London, so I watched it. It was cool. I mean, the only thing was like I had my manager sat next to me for the entire film, and I was like, this is completely awkward. I was like, just do not look at me in any kind of scene like that. I was like, just don't look at me.
How did that whole all come about?
It was just it came from just people out in the States. They heard the song, and it was written for my record, so it was kind of complete chance that it happened. I knew that they were kind of trying to place the song for a while and in the film, but I didn't know it was going to definitely be used. And then when I kind of saw it on the soundtrack, like as track two, I was like, wow, that's amazing. Yeah,
that's so exciting. Like, what are you most proud of with this album?
I think for me, it's just the fact that I've made the album that I wanted to make. So I think for me, it was about just making the music that I loved and, you know, not compromising on that musically. So I think that was just important. And, you know, I'm just proud of the record. And it sounds how I had in my head when I started the process of making the record. So.
Yeah. When it comes to your music and putting it out there, what do you want fans to take away from it? What's sort of the message? Or
I think, you know, people, I think as long as they just interpret, I like it when people kind of take it, you know, song, that they feed their own experience through it and they kind of take it into their world. So lyrically and things, it's a personal record for me. So I kind of like it when I get messages, you know, from people that are like, this song, they interpret it into their own kind of situation and experience. And I think, you know, that's how I like to listen to music, and so hopefully people will take that from it.
You worked with John Legend on a track also on your album. How was that experience? I feel like he's just someone everyone wants to work with.
He's just I was writing for the album out in LA, and we actually just went into the studio quite late, like 8 o'clock at night, and we wrote Hardest Part just literally around a piano and recorded it that night, just keys and vocals, and it was incredible. I mean, he's an amazing musician.
Yeah.
So like I just felt like the whole writing with him just felt really just natural, and it was just really chilled. So I loved the song that we wrote together, so I'm very, very excited.
Did he give you any advice or anything about the industry or anything like that?
I think he's just I like his approach to music and the fact that he you know, he's incredibly talented, like what he does, and I think I like the fact he just does what he wants to do.
Yeah.
And I think that's important, like as an artist, just to kind of make sure that you're always doing the music that you want to do, and you know, not be afraid to kind of say no to stuff, and you know, just make sure that it's musically like what you love.
What are your plans for a tour coming up this year?
Well, I'm flying to LA tomorrow, so I'm gonna be doing some support shows with Years and Years.
Oh, cool! They're so good. Yeah, oh my gosh,
they're
love
amazing.
Them.
So we're doing like Troubadour next week, which I'm excited
That's
about, and then San
good
Francisco,
venue.
And then hopefully I'll be back out in the States like over the summer as well.
Any thoughts of working on a next album? Or are you kind of?
Yeah, no, I've already started.
Really?
Yeah.
I love that. How deep in are you?
I think for me it's like I'm always kind of needing to write.
You're just a creative songwriter, I mean, yeah.
Like whether it's just, you know, picking up a guitar and just messing around with ideas. I mean, I've got like, it's just, I'm really kind of thinking about where I want to take the next record. So I've got a few songs that are kind of, I'm excited about. So I'm just working on that the next couple of months as well. Yeah.
Is there anything that you learned, a lesson that you learned from this album that you kind of are translating to this next one as of right now? It might be too early to tell, but is there anything that comes to mind?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, for me, it's like I always write from like in a kind of reactive way. So whatever I'm sort of feeling is what comes out. And I think for me, it's like just not overthinking it as well is quite important. So, I think just creatively, I'm just kind of ready to get back into the studio now and just start the next record.
That's awesome. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And good luck the rest of your South By.
Oh, thank you for having me.
And I'm excited to talk to you when your next album comes out.
Amazing.
Let's do it. And you guys, of course, for more on Laura, be sure to head to Hollywire.com and Hollywire TV, and we'll see you later.